Hello everyone, I have a case in here. This is a very common issue for iPhone 13 series. Okay. So, the white screen issue. Whatever the color is, it is just plain. You didn't drop the phone. You didn't get water damage. Then it would be the screen itself, the manufacturer problem. Okay. One of the common disease. There are some pins in here. Somehow, it has lost the voltage. So we will cause it like this way. So let's try the jumper method. If the jumper can fix it, then no need to replace the whole screen. Shut down by unplug the battery first. Okay, actually I can just do it like this way, but it will inconvenience. Afraid somehow will broke the flex of here, okay, the cable. So better don't take the risk. Since I'm recording, usually I don't need to remove the shield at all, but I need to get under the camera. So that's why the hustle need to remove the shield. Okay, there we go. So put under the microscope so that you can see clearly what should be done. Okay, so from the left side, you see there's a lot of dots. That's point. Those dots that are responsible for something, you know, for the IC, for the power link, voltage. By the way, I'm not the founder of this issue. So in middle of the lane here, the second row, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, this one, this guy need to be scratched. Do not scratch too deep. It just leather will be enough for the jumper. We are going to make the jump. So this one would be enough. So number 8 from the middle row, and the right side number 6 or 7. Let's try 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If this one is not the one, then it will be the next one. Actually, we can power up the screen and to measure ourselves to know whether this dot, how many voltage is receiving. So, now we use the soldering tip. Do not put too high the temperature. Do not touch it too long. You sure don't want to burn the screen behind. So I would advise you just hike the cable a little and come to here. Okay, so it is done. So it will be look like this to here. So what's left is we boot up the test. If it works, we still better do some modification. We add a resistor between them. So then, whatever happened that side, it won't be affect the whole display at all. Okay, so let's put up and see. Yeah, voila, it works. Okay. So got it? Not easy. So that's it for the sharing. I will remove this jumper carefully to stick it aside. So in my experience, this won't last longer. You know, somehow one of the day he will become broken again and it might be cannot be recovered anymore. So I since quite many cases, direct jumper, it doesn't last very long. It's best you add a resistor between. So then whatever happened in one side, it won't kill the other side. At least you have some protection, you know. So in iPhone 6 or whatever the circuit, you search for the reset line. Okay, you just type reset and usually it comes with the resistor that is quite high. Okay? So in my case, I would choose the reset because the LCD deadline is still running the 1.8 power, 1.8 volt. And you look for that resistor, it should be behind here. This resistor is 100K, but it is strong enough. So just get iPhone 6. Okay, I will take this one. And then between here, either one of the side, you just add in the resistor. Okay, it is the same, left and right. Remember, put your temperature, the soldering tip, very low. I don't want you burn through the screen. Okay, some idiot, he somehow burned through the screen, causing the other side has a big yellow dot. So just like this, okay, a resistor before reaching to the dot. And then the jumper, just like this. So it is done. Clean up a little and put the UV glue. When you clean up, do not use something too strong. Okay, last example. Turn it on. Okay. Done. If you wonder how long the warranty I will provide, actually is quite short. It will be just a month. Not because I'm not confident with the jumper. It's because this kind of screen is very fragile. Okay, you drop it hard or you get the water damage, it could be a same symptom, but the damage is different. Okay, it might cannot be repaired at all. The symptoms look the same, but it would be the screen damage or the other things. So you don't know how the owner use it. Don't try to provide the warranty too long for it. So one last thing is eject the SIM. So then I can check, is it airtight? Is it still water resistance after I have repaired? So after I squeeze the ball here, the pressure shouldn't drop. If it stay, then it means they're good. Airtight, the water is really hard to get in. The water resistance seal is still good condition. If you get something like this, it means it is already leaking somewhere around the screen. Then you better tell the customer the water resistance is not working anymore. Okay, let me show you my old iPhone, iPhone 7. As you can see, I done a lot of modification, open, close, say the screen numbers of time. When the phone still has the water resistance, it will be like this. So let's see. See, the needle is dropped that slow. Somewhere is still leaking, the water still can enter, but it is stronger than the iPhone 13 Pro here. So I have to reopen the screen and put on a new seal. We have a bunch of the seal in here. This is for the screen. It's between the screen and the housing. Okay? We need to take out the screen, clean up the old glue, the old sticker, and put on this one, and then install the screen. Once the screen has been opened, every time, almost every time, we need to replace the seal. So I will not gonna record how I replace this one. This is not today of the video. Hi everyone, I'm Lim. This issue is very common for the iPhone 13 Pro and Pro Max. Many people saying it has happened after the iOS update. Somehow the iOS changed the voltage of the LCD and killed the line. But I already have seen it, the case, already have people claim the warranty when the iPhone 13 just released the first patch of the iPhone 13. They do have the same problem. So the software will not solve your problem. Also, I have seen the LCD that have different version, even for the same model. When you look at the dots you count, you might have a different layout, a different line. So this is why just now I mentioned from the right side, it could be the 6 or 7. Even from the left side, it could be the 7 or the 8. But whatever is it, since if you are the technician, you can measure it by scratching the dot and measure the voltage when you have the display. I mean, even the screen is all plain color, white screen, green screen, whatever is it, you can measure the voltage. It will be different compared to the working screen. So if you are a patient, you can scratch all the dots. You do the research yourself. Some cases they are easy, you just need to hold a little strength from there. Okay, you can resolder those dots and you are back to working. Again, I'm not the founder of this issue. Whoever who found this problem, I quite appreciate. Okay, because I will start looking from there. As for the resistor, actually I have fixed quite many devices the same problem like this. I do a direct jumper, they do return. Somehow the line that you're borrowing the power to that line is Q as well, so it's best you add a resistor between. As for the resistor, you can choose a lower spec, even 30k, 40k, no problem. But any lower than that, he will pull all the current over there. Try not to let it pull too much of the 1.8. Well, we'll not discuss it too deep. I will discuss it in my private study group online course. So once again, the Apple is giving us the money again to our kind of the technician. You know, I kind of like know this ever since the iPhone 6 Plus, the touch problem, no matter how many screen you place, the touch still doesn't work. It is not a touch IC problem. It is a design manufacturer problem. We need to make a jumper, blah, blah, blah. So ever since that generation until today, kind of like each generation, it has the defect, a weakness. Some people call it disease. A same disease, it means a same cure, a same solution, which will be a easy money. So I do hope you don't destroy your customer LCD. Try to suggest this solution first. You can apply. Just don't charge the money if it doesn't work. Okay, what's the harm? And I guess that's it for the video. And I see you on the next one. Bye.